Hi folks, System Qualification Test or SYS.5. In this video, we will address this process. You will learn what the three most important aspects are that you need to consider when conducting system qualification tests according to Automotive SPICE. My name is Bhaskar Vanamali, and I'm a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. As you may have seen in my other videos, I'm a very experienced assessor with more than 140 formal assessments and the training of more than 250 assessors, plus numerous improvement projects under my belt. Okay, let's get started. What is the system qualification test? The expectation is that you already have system requirements in place, so the goal is to check against these requirements and determine if they are fully met and correctly implemented. System tests usually include environmental, performance, and endurance tests. The test environment depends on the product. Examples are hardware in the loop, often abbreviated as HIL, vehicle tests, and climate chambers. In a project, you want to deliver the agreed results on time, on budget, and in the quality required by the customer. Since this process is carried out shortly before delivery, there are close relationships to processes such as project management, MAN3, configuration management, SUB8, product release, SPL2, and of course, system requirements analysis, SYS2. This process is the final stage of the testing and should ensure that the product works as intended by the developing organization and as expected by the customer. If the system qualification test does not work well, errors can go undetected and customer satisfaction is going to drop. So what are aspects you should manage in this process? Aspect 1. You need a test strategy. Like all testing and supporting processes, system qualification test requires the development and definition of a test strategy. You may have separate test strategies for each test level, but it is better to develop and coordinate the test strategy across all test levels. This ensures that all requirements are covered and redundancies are avoided. The test strategy should cover the following topics: the test object in question, the methods for developing test cases and the test data, like for instance, development of positive and negative test cases, equivalence class testing, boundary value testing, a regression test strategy, which in Automotive SPICE terminology means that you define how you want to retest after bug fix or a change request, the test environment, the test coverage in relation to the project plan and the release plan, entry and exit criteria, and test interruption criteria. Of course, this process has a very strong relationship with SUB9 problem resolution management. So you can either use the test strategy or the problem resolution management strategy on how to deal with failed tests. Part of the strategy is also to define coverage targets based on the type of delivery. So here is a strong link to project plan and the release plan. When you document a test strategy, parts of it can be generic and covered in the internal process description and guidelines. Again, Automotive SPICE does not define how and where you document your test strategy. It can be distributed over several documents. The test strategy should also cover your approach to test automation. Generally, it can be said that test automation is always better than manual testing, but there may be tests that are too expensive to automate, or the test environment does not allow this, like for instance in vehicle maneuvers. Aspect 2. Selection of test cases. This process also expects a corresponding selection of test cases to be performed for the various tests. The aim and expectation is that for the different deliveries, the system is properly tested on the basis of the aforementioned test strategy. The idea is that you can have deliveries with different expectations. A possible strategy could be that you have complete coverage of all implemented system requirements for the important deliveries. For smaller deliveries, only the delta of implemented requirements since the last delivery is tested. For this approach, of course, the right test cases must be selected. Another possible situation for test case selection would be the regression test, which covers change requests and/or bug fixes. Here, test cases are selected that cover the change request or bug and the effects that they can have. That means that dependencies on requirements that can be affected by the change request or the bug fix are also tested. Aspect 3, traceability and consistency. This process also requires that you ensure traceability between your system test cases and the system requirements. Traceability can be established through hyperlinks like DAWs, through specific traceability tools like Rectify, through traceability matrices, or through other manageable means which are supported by your tool landscape. The purpose of traceability is that it supports consistency checks, like for instance checking the completeness and correctness of the coverage of the system requirements, that it supports the impact assessment in case of change requests or bugs, and last but not least, it supports the reporting of stakeholder expectations and identifies which requirements have been tested, often referred to as coverage reports. The second part of this aspect is about consistency. Consistency can only be proven in a review where you show that you covered the system requirements completely and correctly. If you skip this review, you may have incomplete or faulty system test cases. The worst part is that you may not even notice the defects in the system qualification test because this test is performed against the system requirements. If these are faulty, your tests may not show false behavior. So this review is really important. Would you like to learn more about system qualification test? We have created a more detailed white paper that you can download for free by clicking on the link below. If you are interested in Automotive SPICE, you can subscribe to this channel. We provide expert knowledge on a regular basis, and don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. Finally, thanks for watching, good luck and goodbye.